Namaste friends, welcome to Bano Biology Center for True Learning. Here I request you to subscribe to my YouTube channel Bano Biology Center for more videos, more updates and more notifications. In this video, we will learn human female reproductive system. Female reproductive system of human beings consists of ovaries, fallopian tubes, uterus, vagina, accessory glands and vulva. So this is the female reproductive system, so present in the females. Here we talk about each part of the female reproductive system in detail. So before going to that, so we better to understand the labeling of the given picture. These are the pair of ovaries. And these are the fallopian tubes. This much of portion is called uterus. This part is called vagina. There are some accessory glands, Bartholin glands. In this picture, you can see the Bartholin glands. The last part is vulva. So this is the external genitalia in the human females. Of course, we will learn about each one in detail. The first we look at primary sex organs in females. They are ovaries. Primary sex organs in human females are called ovaries. Ovaries are responsible for production of ovum and sex hormones. The female gametes are produced by the ovaries. A pair of ovaries present on the both sides of the uterus. This is the one ovary, this is the another ovary. Inside the ovary, secondary oocyte, I mean egg or ovum is formed. Along with that, some steroid hormones or female sex hormones also synthesized there, like estrogen and progesterone. Obviously, ovary is located one on each sides of the lower abdomen. The length of each ovary, is 2 to 4 centimeters. These ovaries are attached to the pelvic wall and uterus with ligament called mesovarium. This portion, this muscular fibrous thread-like structure is called mesovarium. With the help of mesovarium, ovaries are attached to the uterus and as well as to the pelvic wall. This mesovarium make the ovaries in their position constantly. The place of attachment is called hilus. Where the ovaries are attached is called hilus. Ovary is covered by thin epithelium called germinal epithelium. This is the section of ovary. This outermost envelope or layer is a very thin. It is made up of epithelium called germinal epithelium. Germinal epithelium is further enveloped by visceral peritoneum. I mean, one more layer is present on the germinal epithelium called visceral peritoneum. This is the germinal epithelium. Above that, so one more visceral peritoneum is also present. Then this is the ovarian stroma. This inner portion is called ovarian stroma. This ovarian stroma is divided into two regions. One is a ovarian cortex. This is the ovarian stroma. So this portion is called ovarian cortex. This much of cortex is called ovarian cortex. Next, another region of ovarian stroma is ovarian medulla. This central part, this much of central part is called a medullary region. So let us look at ovarian cortex. Ovarian cortex is the outer portion of the ovary, as earlier I said you. It contains, this cortex region contains many primordial follicles. The number may be in thousands. They are called primordial. These are the primordial follicles. Each primordial follicle has one oocyte surrounded by granulosa cells. This is the oocyte. each primordial cell contain one oocyte which is surrounded by the group of cells called granuloid cells. Each month, one primordial follicle progress towards ovulation through different stages of development. This primordial cell progress itself into different developmental stages to form complete egg or ovum. This oocyte is covered by different layers. This is the oocyte, right? This is the oocyte surrounded by the different layers like zona pellucida, theca externa and theca interna. So this is the outermost layer, theca externa, below that theca interna, below that granulosa, below that follicular fluid is present. Cells of theca interna produce androgen, that is sex hormone estrogen. Next, cells of theca externa do not have endocrine function. Only theca interna perform the endocrine function and secretes the female steroid hormone, sex hormone, that is estrogen. Next, fluid filled space is called antrum. Here it is very clearly appearing. This much of fluid filled space is called antrum. At this stage, the complete follicle is called a Graafian follicle. The mass of granuloid cells surround the oocyte called cumulus oophorus. This is the oocyte. So many group of cells cover or envelop this oocyte called cumulus oophorus. Then another region of the ovarian stroma is ovarian medulla. Ovarian medulla is highly vascular stroma found in the center of the ovary. This much of portion is called ovarian medulla. It forms from embryonic mesenchyme during the embryonic development in the mother womb. It contains blood vessels, lymphatic vessels and nerves. Here this is the place where blood vessels, lymphatic vessels and nerves enters the ovarian medulla. It forms the tissue of the hilum. Already I told you, hilum is the place where ovaries are attached to the uterus. This part, medulla part, does not contain any ovarian follicles. The ovarian follicles only present in the ovarian cortex region only. Next part of female reproductive system is fallopian tubes. A pair of fallopian tubes presented. The length of each fallopian tube is 10 to 12 cm. The main functioning of fallopian tube is transport egg or ovum from ovary to the uterus. This part is uterus. The egg is released here. Here fallopian tube collects the released secondary oocyte and transport through its passage and finally make it reaches the uterus region. Fallopian tubes, also known as uterine tubes, are salpinges. Fallopian tube generally composed of four parts or four segments. The first one is infundibulum. From here to here, this region is the infundibulum region. From here to here represents the ampullary region or ampulla. The third segment is isthmus. From here to here, this much of portion is isthmus region. This funnel shaped part very close to the ovary is called infundibulum. This funnel shaped part very clearly shown to us, appear to us, it is very closer to the funnel shaped structure called infundibulum. So it has so many finger like projections. These projections are called fimbriae attendens. This fimbriae ciliated, it mainly collects the released oocyte or egg from the ovary. The wider part of oviduct is called ampulla. This much of wider part is called ampulla. Actually, the fertilization takes place at this place. The fertilization or fusion of male and female gametes happens in the region of ampulla. This narrow lumen part is called isthmus. this isthmus part of fallopian tube actually joins with the uterus part. Thank you for listening video.